Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Please welcome Steven from the Lego Company.
Hey, good morning, everybody. How are you? It's going to be a great day today. I just want to tell you I've been given 10 minutes to actually do a little presentation just before the keynotes will start. So in 10 minutes, all the excitement will start, but I'll show you a couple of things here. I just want to tell you about how we from LEGO have embraced developers out there. So, but some of you found the bricks on your seats, and I just have a little question for you, which is, so how many different combinations do you think you can actually put these bricks together? And please do not Google that. That would be cheating. You might get to the answer before the end of the presentation. So we at LEGO, we have a big mission, which is to inspire and develop the builders of tomorrow. We want to create and make children become creative thinkers and problem solvers and prepare them for the future and the challenges out there. We also make products for children of all ages. And more so, we've seen how people out there have expanded our products and taken beyond its boundaries. And most of all, with the LEGO Mindstorms robotic toolkit, which came out in 1998. We made a robotic toolkit that was prepared for children from age 12 and up, with proprietary software, customized hardware, and software to boot. But apparently, this product also appeared to adults. So within the first 5 months after we launched back in 1998, our product got hacked. The hardware, our proprietary hardware and software got hacked. The components, all our vital components were put in a shopping list on the internet. Our legal department was freaking out. And they wanted to take action. They wanted to take these people down and stop them right there. But we said, let's see what happened. And actually, this was not harmful. Actually, it expanded. It actually started the community around it of the adult fans out there. So actually, we learned some lessons that when we, in 2004, wanted to introduce a new generation of LEGO Mindstorms, which we launched in 2006, we said, let's embrace all these developers out there because they will hack our products anyway. That's one of the lessons we learned. They will take our pieces apart. So let's see what we can do and actually take these people in. And also another important lesson is that these guys knew more about the product than we did. I certainly believe that. So how do you go about actually finding these fans out there who actually know more about these developers that we need to bring in? Well, as I said, there was a community that had developed and formed around LEGO Mindstorms, which was quite a first for LEGO. And as you can see, we call adult fans, A4s, adult fans of LEGO. Well, it's actually a name they made up themselves, but we adapted to that and we're working with these guys. And I find that they're really, really strong when it comes to LEGO Mindstorms products. So back in 2004, we actually opened up a little web forum, closed web forum, invited four people in, which we called the forum the Mindstorms User Panel, hence the name The Muppets. It was their own nickname they came up with again. But what we did was we invited these people in into our whole list of places, into an R&D. You wouldn't normally have people invited into your R&D just coming from the outside. Of course, they signed the agreement. But we took a calculated risk. This time, we did not ask the lawyers for permission because we found it would be better to actually ask just for forgiveness. Thank you. So as you can see in this picture, we have on the left side here, Steve and David talking to our designers, sorting out elements. They actually came up with new elements that we hadn't thought about. They actually suggested an ultrasonic sensor that we hadn't thought about because some of the old... In the old generation, some of the fans had actually hacked and made their own sensors, right? So, also today, what we see is a great amount of software applications that has been made because we said, let's go open source with all this. Let's open up to the community. So today, on our website, you can find a software developer kit, a firmware developer kit, a hardware developer kit, and a Bluetooth developer kit. All for the sake of proliferating our products. And it's the fans who have actually born our whole product as it is today. As you can see with all the names of all these different software applications, there are no limits and boundaries to what you can actually do with this. So if any of you guys out there actually have played with LEGO Mindstorms or have helped expand our products, I salute you and thank you. Keep pushing. We definitely appreciate that. But also, of course, on the model sides, I could talk for hours about the thousands and thousands of inventions that fans have made up there, of all ages. I guess we're all children inside, especially that's what we believe at Lego. But as you can see, getting a robot to solve a Rubik's Cube, yeah, you can make that. There are instructions for that on the internet. Getting to interface with the iPhone, you can do that as well. Making work with Android would probably be the next thing coming. Also, if you want to have the perfect game of Wii, I actually met the inventor last night. It was really a thrill. So we recognized that these guys really expanded that. Getting to fetch your soda cans. There's some product placement right here. But yeah, you can do that as well. There are no limits to what you can do with this. But as I said, I salute the guys out there who are actually working on this. Last year, in 2008, we had the ultimate drop test. We actually sent some of our robots up in a balloon that went to the edge of the atmosphere. And one of them actually got dropped from up there, from 80,000 feet up. It deployed a parachute, but actually came down quite safe, but it was the ultimate drop test for us. Native Chris Anderson from the Bay Area, famed from Wired magazine, actually made a Lego UAV. He wanted to prove that he could make a UAV, unmanned aerial vehicle, for under $1,000. And he chose our products that control the plane, which is quite amazing. We've been into space. We've been cleaning up the space station together with the Russians. This goes back a while, but we're going to go into space again. So, back to my original question. How many different combinations did you figure out was in it? The tally would probably be, some of you might have this number, 102,901,500 different combinations. But that has actually been recalculated by a Danish math professor. So in essence, there are 915,103,765,000,000. If any of you guys had that combination, please email me. So enjoy the rest of the day, guys. This was it for me. And thank you. Keep up the development with Mindstorms.